बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। माय नेम इज़ मोहम्मद फुरकान। फ्रॉम टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस रेट। सो बिफोर डिस्कसिंग रेट, आई वांट टू टेल यू दैट इन द एंड ऑफ दिस वीडियो आई विल गिव यू होमवर्क फॉर दिस वीक एंड फॉर नेक्स्ट वीक। सो काइंडली वॉच दिस वीडियो टिल द एंड। रेट इज़ द कंपेरिजन ऑफ टू क्वान्टिटीज। इट इज़ अ स्पेशल टाइप ऑफ रेशो इन विच टू आइटम्स आर इन डिफरेंट यूनिट्स। ऑफन द सेकेंड यूनिट इज टाइम, सच एज पर सेकेंड, पर मिनट एंड पर आवर। बट इट कैन बी एनी थिंग, फॉर एग्जाम्पल माइल्स पर आवर, कैलरीज पर सेकेंड, स्टेप्स पर डे एंड हर्ट बीट्स पर मिनट। फॉर एग्जाम्पल अ स्टूडेंट स्टडीज 5 hours a day. How much time does he spend in 7 days? In this question, the rate is already given, that is 5 hours a day, and he is asking to find the total amount of time he will spend in 7 days. So it is quite simple. When the rate is already given, what you do, simply multiply the rate with the second quantity. When you multiply it by second quantity, you will be having the total amount of time or whatever you want to calculate. So simply multiply 5 hours by 7. 5 sevens are 35. So 35 hours is the amount of time he will spend in 7 days. He will spend 35 hours in 7 days. So let's solve some more questions to learn how to calculate rate. Our first question is, Mr. Lee pays $3 to park for 1 hour. How much does he pay to park for 5 hours? In this question, again the rate is given $3 for 1 hour and the time is given 5 hours. We need to find the total amount he will spend in 5 hours. So let's do a solution. First of all, we will write the data from this question. Rate is given $3 per hour and time is 5 hours. We will calculate the total amount he will spend . So again, it is quite simple. When the rate is given, just multiply that rate with the second quantity that is given. You will be having the total amount of rupees or the time you are going to calculate. So simply multiply 3 by 5, $3 multiply by 5 hours. $3.15 is your answer. So we will write our answer into words. Mr. Lee spends $15 to park for 5 hours. Let's solve some more examples. Mr. Chin works part-time and is paid $8 per hour. He was paid $576 in March. How many hours did Mr. Chin work in March? In this question, the rate is given $8 and the total amount paid is given 576. We need to find the total time he worked in March. So let's calculate. Rate is $8 per hour and total amount paid $576. We need to calculate total time. When calculating total amount, we will multiply, and when calculating total time or the rate, we will divide. So let's solve. 576 divided by 8. Divided by 8. 8 1 the 8, 8 7 the 56. 1 is remaining, and this will become 16. 8 2 the 16. 72 hours. It means Mr. Chin worked 72 hours in March. Our next question is, Mr. Tan's family used 927 kilowatt of electricity for 30 days. At this rate, how much electricity does Mr. Tan's family use per day? In this question, we will calculate rate. So let's start. Electricity use and total time or total days is equal to 30. To find rate, we will divide 927 by 30. So rate is equal to 927 divided by 30. When you divide 927 its answer will be 30.9 kilowatt per hour. So Mr. Tan's family used Mr. Tan's family used 30.9 of electricity per day. Our last question is, a factory makes 3,234 toys in 7 hours. At this rate, how many toys can the factory make per hour? Now in this question, it is asked to find rate total number of toys are given 3,234 and the time is given 7 hours. Again, as I told you, to find rate, we have to divide the total number or the total amount by the time. So rate is equal to 3,234 divided by 7. So let's divide it by 7. 3,234. 7. 7 4s are 28. 4 is remaining. This will become 43. And 7 6 are 42. And now this will become 14. 7 2s are 14. So the factory makes 462 toys per hour. The factory makes 462 per hour. I hope the concept of rate is clear to you and this video will help you in your homework. Thank you so much. Allah Hafiz.